dear students, welcome to the online video lecture on fluid mechanics. So hope the whatever concepts we have discussed in the previous video, so you have understood all those concepts. So today in this video we are going to start with a new concept. So without wasting much time, let us begin with our session. So hello my dear students, today we are going to derive the discharge for the orifice meter. So what is this orifice meter or orifice plate? So orifice is a device used to measure the rate of flow of liquid through a pipe. So, and even this orifice meter works on the same principle as that of venturi meter. So this is a simple schematic diagram of an orifice meter, what you are observing. So this consists of a flat circular plate, okay, and a hole will be there at the center of this plate, and this hole will be concentric with respect to the diameter of a pipe. And generally whatever hole is there at this concentric plate, at this circular plate, it is 0.5 times of this pipe diameter, okay, it is 0.5 times of this diameter. Now this is a simple, and this is U2 manometer is connected. Okay, let us start with a derivation. Let P1, V1 and A1 be the pressure, velocity and cross-sectional area at section 1. Similarly, P2, V2, A2 are the pressure, velocity and cross-sectional area at section 2. Now applying the Bernoulli's principle to this at section 1 and 2, so we have P1 divided by rho g plus V1 square divided by 2g plus Z1 will be equals to P2 divided by rho g plus V2 square divided by 2g plus Z2. So by applying Bernoulli's principle we will get this equation. Now, so I will shift the, interchange the terms, I will take velocities at one section and remaining terms to another section. That is P1 divided by rho g plus Z1 and minus P2 divided by rho g plus Z2 will be equals to V2 square divided by 2g minus V1 square divided by 2g. Okay, so now this P1 by rho g plus Z1 minus P2 by rho g plus Z2 is a difference in the pressure head. So that is known as differential head. So it is given as H. It is denoted by, that is this P1 by rho g plus Z1 minus P2 divided by rho g plus Z2 is a difference in the head. And it is denoted by letter H. Let us substitute that H in this equation. So the now this equation becomes H is equals to V2 square minus V1 square divided by 2G. I will take 2G as a common now. So if I cross multiply this one, so then the equation from this equation, so then I will get velocity V2. I will take V2 outside, and so this will becomes root of 2hg minus v1 square. So it is just this v2 is identified by cross multiplying 2g into h, then I will take this one, so here it will be plus. Okay, so the equation becomes v2 is equals to root of 2hg plus v1 square. Now at section 1, so the Wenner contraction effect is observed. So what is this Wenner contraction effect? So it is a effect observed at a cross section where the cross sectional area is less. At that section the velocity will increases. As the velocity increases, it minimizes the pressure at that section. So here you are observing the reduction in the cross sectional area. So at that is at section 2. So there is a Wenner contraction effect is observed. Therefore this Venau contraction effect at section 2 is a area 2 and this is a orifice area. So that is A0 is a complete orifice area. So this Venau contraction effect is given by coefficient of contraction. So that is coefficient of contraction is equals to A2 divided by A0. So this is a Venau contraction is observed at section 2. Because of that, A2 I have considered. And A0 is a orifice area. Now by this equation, where C is a coefficient of Venau contracta or contraction, you can write it contraction, coefficient of contraction. Now from this equation, I can write A2 will be equals to A0 into C, that is coefficient of contraction. Now by continuity equation, we know that A1 V1 will be equals to A2 V2. This is by continuity equation. Okay. By continuity equation, we know that A1 V1 is equals to A2 V2. Now let us take V1 outside. V1 will be equals to A2 V2 divided by A1. Okay. Let us substitute A2 in this equation. So now this equation changes. V1 will be equals to A0 C V2 divided by A1. Okay. Now if I substitute this A2 here, so my V1 will becomes this. That is A0 into coefficient of contraction into velocity at section 2 and A1. So I'll erase these steps for further simplification. Okay. Now this is our velocity. Now let us substitute this velocity V1 in the velocity 2 equation. So that is, we know we have velocity 2 as root of 2GHG plus V1 square and we have V1. So let us substitute this V1 in this equation. So my V2 will be equals to, V2 will be equals to, so that is root of 2HG plus bracket A0, then coefficient of contraction velocity 2 A1 whole square. Okay, now let us, okay, this is the velocity 2. Now I will take this V2 square, remove this root sign. So then it will be 2HG plus A0 C V2 divided by A1. Okay. Now I will shift this complete term to this side. So then it will be V2 square minus A0 C V2 divided by A1 will be equals to 2HG. Okay. 2HG. Now again, if I take V2 outside, okay, so this is square is there, okay, square. So if I take V2 outside, so then I will get a equation V2 square 1. So here 1 will remain. So then again it will be A0 square C square divided by A1 square into 2HG. Now this equation I will get it. Now from this I can get actual, I will erase these steps. Okay. Now from this equation I can get velocity now. So that is velocity 2 will be equals to 2HG divided by 1 minus A0 square C square divided by A1 square. Okay. So this is a equation. Now if I take this square, if I want to remove this square, so then V2 will be equals to root of 2HG divided by root of 1 minus A0 square C square divided by A1 square. Now I have got velocity 2. So let us substitute this discharge at section 2. I will consider, so that is Q is equals to, okay, Q is equals to A2 V2. Now let us substitute this one. Q will be equals to A2, velocity is root 2 hg divided by root of 1 minus a naught square c square divided by a1 square. Okay, again I need to erase this one. So this is equation. Now we know that from contraction, coefficient of contraction, that is coefficient of contraction is given by a2 divided by a naught. Now from this, a2 is equal to c a naught. Okay, now I will replace this a naught by this c into a naught equation. Therefore q is equal to c a naught root of 2 hg divided by root of 1 minus a naught square c square divided by a1 square. Now this is not our complete final equation. Now we have got, again we'll simplify this one, again we'll simplify this one, and the coefficient of discharge, okay, now coefficient of discharge is given by, that is CD for this orifice meter is given by contraction, the coefficient of contraction into root of 1 minus a naught a1 square divided by root of 1 minus a naught a1 whole square into c square. Okay, coefficient of discharge is given by c n. Now I need to identify this value now. Okay, now I will take this complete term outside. Okay, now I will take c outside, so then coefficient of contraction will becomes cd, that is coefficient of discharge into, it is a cross multiplication, so then it will be root of a naught a1 whole square into c square divided by root of 1 minus a naught a1 whole square. Okay, now after this I have got c, that is contraction, coefficient of contraction value. Now let us substitute this coefficient of contraction in this equation, that is in discharge equation. Therefore q will be equals to cd into root of 1 minus a naught a1 whole square c square divided by root of 1 minus a naught divided by a1 square. Okay, will be equals to a naught, then that is root 2 hg divided by root of 1 minus a naught square c square a1 square. Now so this equation will be get cancelled. Okay, so this equation will be get cancelled. Now final q will be equals to cd into, so I will just change this equation, so that is a naught root 2 hg divided by root of 1 minus a naught divided by a1 whole square. So if I simplify this one, then q will be equals to cd into a naught root of 2 hg, okay, divided by a1 square minus a naught square. whole divided by a1 square. Now if I take this a1 outside, so then this will becomes, then this will becomes a1. Okay, therefore our final, okay, I will write it a1 square. Now I'll take this a1 outside. Okay, then I will take this a1 outside, therefore my final q equation will becomes cd a0 a1 root of 2hg divided by root of a1 square minus a0 square. So this is our final equation for venture orifice meter, discharge through the actual discharge through the orifice meter. But compared to the venturi meter, this having some additional steps in this venturi orifice meter. So this is our actual discharge through the orifice meter. Now where CD is a discharge coefficient of discharge, and this CD will be lesser than the CD of a venturi meter. That is very important. The CD of orifice meter will be lesser compared to CD of venturi meter. So this is our final discharge equation. And so we have some of the merits and demerits of this orifice meter. Whereas orifice meter, the merits of orifice meter are, orifice meter is simple in construction, and as it is simple in construction, the cost of installation and replacement will be also very economical compared to orifice venturi meter. Because venturi meter is, when compare the design of venturi meter and orifice meter, so orifice meter design is bit complicated compared to this venturi meter design is bit complicated compared to orifice meter. So this orifice meter is simple in construction, and installation cost and replacement will be very economical, and it requires less space to install compared to the venturi meter. If we compare the venturi meter dimension and this orifice meter dimension, so this will be have take a less space to install it. Then the demerits of this orifice meter are, one is, this orifice meter is not so accurate as the venturi meter. Okay, the if I take the readings for a same flow, if I want to calculate the discharge for a same pipe, if I use both these venturi as well as orifice meter, so I will get more accurate results in a venturi meter. So these orifice meter will have a very less accurate compared to venturi meter. Again, the losses are more in the orifice meter. So these are the two drawbacks of this orifice meter. One is, it is not accurate compared to the venturi meter, and another one is, the orifice, in orifice meter the losses are more. Okay, so these are the two demerits. And merits, it is simple in construction, replacement and installation cost will be economical, and it requires less space to install. So this question will be asked in the examination for 10 marks. So derive the discharge to the orifice meter and write its merits and demerits. So this question will be asked in the examination for 10 marks. Okay, and this is a final equation for discharge to the orifice meter.